Today we're going to make a peach cobbler using Dollar Tree ingredients. A few months ago I bought two packages of this Betty Crocker sugar cookie mix, and I made cookies out of them and I was not impressed. Even though Betty Crocker generally has a good name, the cookies weren't really anything to write home about. They'd be okay, you know, if you're baking something with your kids or your grandkids, or you just want something to fuss around with, but you know, to bring to an event or something, I don't know, they just were not working. So I looked for other recipes that I could use this mix for, because it was good enough, just not for cookies, and I came across using them as a cobbler topping. So I'm going to give that a try using the sugar cookie mix, and we're going to be making a peach cobbler today. So I bought two of these bags of frozen peaches at Dollar Tree, and we'll see how this all comes out. Okay, our first order of business is going to be preparing the pan and getting the peaches in there. I use Dollar Tree spray oil. They have coconut, they have I think canola, maybe olive oil. They've just got different brands of this. I use coconut oil for no particular reason, but it works and it's great, and a dollar is far less than what I've paid for this in other retail establishments. Okay, so I have the pan sprayed down. You can see it's about this big. It's like about a pie pan size. And I'm going to check out these peaches. Let me show you what it looks like inside right now. Each one of these packages is 12 ounces. So we'll have 24 ounces of peaches in there, and I'm not concerned about that, because fruit does cook down. I was going to get canned peaches, but I couldn't find them, and now I think maybe the frozen peaches are better, because there's not any of that juice. It's just peaches. They smell like peaches, they look like peaches, and truthfully, if you have to choose between canned fruit or vegetables or frozen, always go for the frozen. They're usually frozen from ripe, without a lot of processing. If you do get canned canned vegetables or fruit, be sure to rinse them off really well. So I'm gonna set this aside and we'll start working on our sugar cookie topping. All right, now for the sugar cookie topping. Put that in the bowl there. When I add wet ingredients to dry in baking, what I like to do is basically make a hole in the middle of the dry ingredients so the wet ingredients can go, and then start stirring in such a way that eventually all the dry ingredients are incorporated into the wet. So the recipe calls for a tablespoon of water, so I measured one out, put that in the middle, and it called for a quarter cup of butter or margarine, which had which was at room temperature. So I could actually put the whole thing in, but I'm not going to. I'm going to take, I'm going to take a knife. I like to do this too, is just take a knife and kind of break it up a little bit ahead of time. Try to aim as much of it as I can into the hole that I created in the dry ingredients. Take a few minutes here, but it's worth it. They said not to melt it. Otherwise, I would have thrown it in the microwave and be done with it. People also grate margarine or butter to get the blocks broken up like that. It's kind of a decision you'll have to make depending on the recipe and the circumstances. I find it kind of messy, actually. I've done it and it just takes forever to get off the grater, but there are times when you're going to want to do that. All right, I'm going to get a couple different tools because I'm not sure which one's going to work best for mixing this, so I'll be back in a moment. I have both a fork and a pastry cutter, and we'll see which one does a better job of mixing the water and the flour and the cookie mix together. I'll probably end up using a little bit of both. I said to get it kind of crumbly. The fork seems to be doing okay. You can also use two knives sort of together like this. I find it somehow annoying the way people feel when somebody scratches their fingers against a chalkboard. I get that same feeling when I'm trying to do pie crust with two knives. I don't know, something about it is disturbing on a deep psychological level. So I'll either use this or I'll use the pastry cutter, which I think I'm going to use for a minute here. It looks like this. It has blades or, you know, in a curved shape, and it's good for just mixing stuff up a little bit, especially when you have pie crusts or anything with some hard material in it, like butter or margarine. It just helps break it all up and mix it up with the dry ingredients. Get that out of there. So far, we've done pretty good. Everything from the dollar store, including the margarine. The margarine is in the refrigerated section. And although I'm using peaches, don't feel bound by that. They've got strawberries in there, and they've got blueberries and mangoes and different sorts of, I think, apricots I've seen there. Different sorts of frozen fruit in there, so you could do whatever you want or mix two fruits together. You might be able to get away with one bag of fruit, but I like, if I'm already going to make a cobbler, I'd like there to be a lot of fruit and plenty of fruit. I just think it tastes better and it looks better, and for another buck, why not have the two bags of fruit? All right, this actually looks like it worked out pretty well. Everything's fairly well incorporated there. I don't think I need that anymore. I'm just going to still a little peel-like. So we'll see what happens next. Okay, until a soft dough forms. So at this point, I'm going to make a soft dough. Just make it into a ball there so I have something to work with. So it seems a little dry, so I might add a little bit more water. Excuse me a moment while I do that. And you can be a very good judge of whether things are too dry or too wet. If it's not holding together real well and it just seems kind of chalky, then there's not enough water. Even though the ingredients might say one thing, a lot of baking is determined by altitude, by weather, by all sorts of factors that are out of your control, which Betty Crocker herself can't even foresee. All right, this looks a little better. All right, I'm going to stage up for the last part, preparing the cobbler and putting it in the oven. I'll be right back. We have our peaches in the pan. I kind of evened them out so they were equally dispersed. I have our dough, and I have a piece of parchment paper on top of a cutting board, and I decided to do that in case the dough sticks. I can still peel it off and put it on top. I'm not quite sure what this dough is going to do. Now, a lot of people flour their hands when they're handling dough. A year or so ago, I went to a baking class, and he said, actually, you don't need to flour your hands. The best thing to do is to just wet your hands, and then you don't add more flour into the batter and dry it out. So my hands are wet, and we'll see how well that advice works. So what I'm going to do, I thought, I'm going to make some I made a ball, and then I'm going to make some just little flat discs. See the little disc there, and try to make, I'm not even sure how many I should make for this. Maybe 10. We'll see if I can get 10 out of this, or I'll lay them out in such a way. Cooking is not an exact science. And the minute you start feeling it's an exact science, that's when you really become good at it. And in a way, it's almost kind of powerful, because you can make anything and do anything, and you can get any sort of ingredient you want and make it work, and that's a pretty cool skill to have. Okay, I'm making these discs. I'm not particularly concerned about their size or anything, as long as they're approximately the same width. I probably could have rolled these out with a rolling pin and a cookie cutter and all that stuff, but it just didn't seem like this was a big enough project for that, getting all that stuff dirty. And if you're a perfectionist, I guess you could cut these out perfectly round and shapes or something, but I just want to make a peach cobbler that everyone's going to enjoy eating, so I don't think it needs all that fancy stuff. We'll done. And I think we'll have enough. It's the perfect amount. All right, so we've got about 8 discs. These are a couple inches wide, varying sizes. And I'm just gonna throw them on top of this cobbler. And that's gonna be our crust. So keep your fingers crossed that this works out as well as it did on the internet. I found the recipe. Here's one. See what I mean about the parchment paper? They're getting a little melty and sticking, and parchment paper just gives you a little bit more control over pulling the dough off. Like that. Over there. Oh, looks like it's gonna be about perfect. Put one there. I want the top to be covered again. Doesn't need to be perfect. Trying to be perfect often holds people back from doing things, as long as it's good and it resembles a cobbler to some extent. I might kind of do that. Move this one over, that one there, and what do you think? I think it looks pretty good. I've warmed the oven up to 350 as per the directions on the cookie dough, and we'll see how long it cooks. I'm not quite sure what's going to happen with the fruit underneath, if that's going to change the cooking time, but I'll start it off, and when it starts looking brown on top or cooked on top, I'll check with a knife to see if it's fairly dry inside, and we'll see you in a few minutes. Well, here it is all cooked. It looks wonderful. It took about 40 minutes. My one regret is that I did not sprinkle the top with sugar, because these are sugar cookies, and I think it would have made things a lot prettier, but it looks pretty good and it smells wonderful. Let me cut a piece for you all to see. The cookie is firm, but it's not stiff. And there you go. You tell me. It's beautiful, it smells wonderful, and would be appropriate for just about every and any occasion. Plus, it only costs $3. 2 packages of fruit and 1 package of sugar cookies. I hope you enjoyed learning about how to make a cobbler with a sugar cookie crust. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.